So what's today's thing again?
Well, the main problem we're going to solve today is make it to where the second floor of this house is cooler so that the kids can be comfortable when they sleep and the AC actually gets to the target temperature of 72 degrees. That's what we're going to try to fix. How's it coming, Adam? What we're doing is putting our... This is Adam. Say hi, Adam. Putting R13 on the walls. You always put the paper facing in. Between this plywood or this OSB and the downstairs, they laid R38. So it is insulated. It's technically an insulated attic. So all this heat, I mean, it's only, what time is it? 10? This is already hot. Like, it's not burning hot, but it's hot. So all that thermal heat, radiant heat's transferring in through the wood. It'll transfer down. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put baffles, and I'll show you. These are called baffles, all right? So these go in first. And they allow airflow from the soffit vents all the way to the ridge vent. So that way we're not blocking air on a cathedral ceiling. That's very important. We're going to stop about right here with the insulation. Then we're going to insulate straight across and then go back down the other side. And then in the peak above us, we're installing two solar attic fans. So if you're going to get started on a project like this, I recommend what I call a slap stapler. These are really nice because you just hammer the staple. Just like that. I still need to put baffles, but I'm just doing this just to show you. So baffles would go all the way there up to about right here. But this kind of rests in the cavity, just like that. And some people will bring the paper over and staple it here, but if you ever put drywall, you got these staples in the way. So it's best if you kind of leave it right there, just like that, just go down. Just like that, and then you just pop it all the way down, but I'm not gonna do it all because we still gotta put baffles behind it, so. So here's your solar pattern. If you want to come over here, it's kind of hard to see. This is their template. So it shows the hole we're going to put in the solar. And then the nice thing about our solar fans is it has a thermostat control mechanism. So in the winter, whenever it's up there, it's got this thing that'll dangle inside the attic. So if the attic gets too chilly, it does not turn on. It's set at 70 degrees, which is really nice. You don't have to worry about these solar fans kicking on because they kick on as soon as solar hits them.
How was your experience working with our team? Were they polite, respectful?
Oh, it's been great. From the moment I called, the office staff was super helpful and sent somebody out within a couple days to give us basically an assessment of the space and what the recommendations were. And then within a short amount of time, a team was out here doing the work. They were timely and courteous, and they left the place clean, probably cleaner than it was before because they were vacuuming my hallway, so that's great.
Oh, all right, great, good to hear. And were you satisfied with the quality of the work that we did for you?
Yes, extremely.